be back.
I would smell, man, that's a...
That's my march. Okay, good evening, or good night.
Afternoon,
whatever it is. Might be night by the time we get this thing going. Apologize for the delay. Ladies and gentlemen, good morning. I would like to welcome our guests of honor, our family, our friends, many of you scouters, and our council representative, Owen McGuire, who's our district executive. Thank you for being here today. Before I begin, I would like to warn you and encourage you at the same time. Denali wanted this banquet to be fun. And I apologize for the awkward silence, and I apologize that Mark didn't do a song, because he would have been great at it. So there will be interactive moments, and they're going to be throughout, and I would encourage you to participate. There are no strobe lights, so if there's any pregnant women, you don't need to worry about the effects of this ride. If you need restrooms, they're out the door to your left. Otherwise, please enjoy. At this time, I would like to call our senior patrol. Senior patrol leader is not here today, so I'm going to make an audible. A lot of audibles today. I would like to ask one of our assistant scoutmasters, Mark Philbrick, if he would assemble the color guard and bring them forward for the presentation of the colors.
Will everyone please stand for the presentation of our nation's colors? Will everyone please join me in reciting the Pledge of Allegiance?
Hand over your heart as a scout salute.
I pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America and to the republic for which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all.
Thank you very much. Appreciate your time, Devin. Okay, if you please remain standing, I would like to invite Denali's grandfather, Clement Fleurent, city councilor, to come up at this time for the invocation.
Well, it's a privilege and a benefit to come before you this morning and do the benediction. And so if we'll bow our head for a moment of prayer. Father, we thank you for this time. We thank you for Denali, for his achievement, Lord. And we thank you that he's called us to be part of his celebration this morning, Lord. We just pray, mighty God, that he will continue to serve you in his leadership, Lord, that he's shown to all of us. We pray this morning, Lord, that as he goes to his summer camp this summer, that he will continue to learn. He will continue to be the service person that you've asked him to be. He will continue to be a leader in his scouts, and he will continue to seek adventure as he goes on to his life, Lord. We know that you've opened up a new chapter in his life, and we pray, mighty God, that you will continue to use him, Lord, as a scout leader, that he will be a mentor to all of those scouts that he will be with this summer, Lord. And we pray that you would be with him as he continues his education in the fall. Father, we pray for those, and we thank you for those that have mentored him throughout his Cub Scouts, Boy Scouts, and through his achievement as an Eagle Scout. We pray, mighty God, that you would bless them. We pray especially for his parents, Lord, Tony and Tammy, that have mentored him through this achievement, and we just thank you for them, and we pray, mighty God, that you would bless them also. Thank you for all of those that are here this morning, and we pray, mighty God, that you would bless them in a mighty way. Thank you for New Life for letting us use their facility this morning. We pray this in Jesus' name. Amen.
Amen.
All right. Thank you, Dad. But before we truly get started, I think it best that we take a walk down memory lane and start off with a camp song to warm us up. Yes, I can't think of a better way today to start us off than thinking of when Denali was just a young boy riding in a little red wagon. And for those of you that don't know the words, just follow along the screen. So, Denali, would you like to lead us?
Sure, I would love to.
Thank you.
All right. You can't ride in the little red wagon. Front seat's broken and the axle's dragging. You can't ride in the little red wagon. Chug, 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 chug. All right, cool. Second verse, same as the first, but a whole heck of a lot louder and a whole heck of a lot worse. You can't ride in the little red wagon. Front seat's broken and the axle's dragging. You can't ride. Harder, better, faster, stronger, all that Daft Punk stuff. All right. You can't ride in the little red wagon. Front seat's broken and the axle's dragging. You can't ride in the little red wagon. Chug, 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 chug.
Thank you, Denali. All right. Now you may be seated.
I got the wrong
guy. Yes, you sit down. Thank you.
Doing good, Mr. Art Lewis.
Yes, Art Lewis had literally a 5-minute training session on the lights, so he's doing the best he can here to help us out. All right, there we go. Okay. So, in 1911, Boy Scouts of America chose the eagle to symbolize, the symbol of man's best became the symbol of scouting's best. And so it is this morning that we honor a scout who has taken up the challenge of the Trail to Eagle and has climbed to its summit. Oops, wrong photo. That's better. May I, this time, introduce our district executive, Owen McGuire, to come forward
Owen!
And present the name of the Eagle Scout.
Owen!
Hi, Owen.
It is truly an honor to be with you all this morning and to recognize the newest Eagle Scout in our district. This young man I've gotten to know over the last few years, and like many scouts coming from Troop Parade, I guess the word I can use is unique. It's probably the best word, the most polite word I could probably use this morning. This young man's scouting spirit is larger than that mat of hair that he somehow manages to keep so elegant. This young man takes scouting, I guess, very seriously and takes what he does very seriously. He is not only an example to the young men of the troop, he's a young man, example to scouts all over New England in his role at that other camp.
Woo!
Winter camp and many other things. I've seen him on multiple occasions working with young scouts, and I truly can say he is probably one of the best in that his project to build the puppet boxes for the theater boxes for the local school earned a lot of praise and filled a very much need. So it's with honor. Privilege that I present the newest Eagle Scout in York District candidate, Denali Fleurent.
I love you all.
Can you do that again?
All right. that's awesome. All right, but before I certify that Denali Myers Fleurent has met all the requirements put forth by the Boy Scouts of America and is eligible to receive an Eagle Scout Award, I would like to test his ability to recreate his famous Spring Camporee song that he did for us at the closing Camporee. Denali, can you lead us in it?
I have a question.
Yes.
I don't think I have enough room.
Do it on the side. Would you please lead us in a rendition of I'm a Cucumber?
Oh. All right, basically, so this song has like 7 words or something like that. I counted off the words enough, which is probably not off the top of my head, but it has like 7. Pretty simple. Just say I'm a Cucumber over and over 6 times, and then you scream, please don't take me to the pickle farm, as loud as you physically can. So it's pretty simple. Most of the scouts here at least know it. It's one of my favorite songs. I learned it at camp, and I brought it back here to Maine, and I like it. So it goes a little something like this. I'm a cucumber! I'm a cucumber! Was that 5 or 6? It was 5. I'm a cucumber! Please don't take me to the pickle-farm! So it goes kind of like that. We're going to do like 2 or 3 more times, and then I'll mix it up a little bit. But I'll keep count this time, I promise. All right. I'm a cucumber! Please don't take me to the pickle farm! All right, cool. So that's the song, and I really like it.
Thank you, Denali. Are we having fun yet? Good. All right. Let's see. At this time, I would like to ask our Assistant Scoutmaster, Gary Russo, longstanding Assistant Scoutmaster and Acting Scoutmaster, to come forward for the acceptance pledge. Gary, would you please come forward? That's for you.
Mr. Eagle Scout Denali Front.
It's me.
Scout Sire. Your name has been presented to this court to be considered for scouting's highest honor, that of Eagle Scout. You are hereby acknowledged in front of your family, friends, invited guests, and fellow scouts.
I think friends might be stretched, but. Well,
some of us are paid.
All.
Fame is required. No, I make a friend.
Right.
Consider yourself worthy of great honor that you have conscious met in good conscience. You've met all requirements as set forth by the Boy Scouts of America.
I do.
Okay. Very well. Please be seated.
Alright, we're not sure this next segment is going to work exactly like we planned it, but we're going to try our best. Will, Troop Committee, absent, Chairman, Jim Wunderlich, please video forward for Denali's Trailed Eagle presentation.
Let's get down to business. To the
Denali for the trip down memory lane. That was awesome. We did have a video from Jim. It didn't play out the way we thought it would, so I apologize for that. Jim, you have us in your hearts in abstentia. There were other notable accomplishments I wanted to share before we move on. And many of you in the room know that Denali and myself spent a lot of time camping over the last 11 years. But I wanted you to look at the actual number of camping days that he recorded. 124 camping days in the last 11 years. Next slide, please. With camp, because I knew he was going to ask that question like he just did, that was an additional 180 days, because he spent last 3 years in a tent, 6 nights a week for 10 weeks straight. So that is a lot of camping days.
Is that including winter camp and Black Earth?
It includes all those other camps in the first number, yes. Now, congratulations, that's a lot of camping days. All right, so consider the badge itself. I thought it's important that many of you know that he's going to be receiving the badge, the patch, and then the actual badge. And a lot of folks in this room may not know what it actually stands for or what it represents, and there's a lot of symbolism in each parts of this. Let's see here. Where am I? Okay. Where is that? Slide 6. Okay. So the training received in the troop prepares a scout, and that's what the be prepared means. Okay, next slide. The knot attached to the bottom of the scroll, as you all can see, represents the scout slogan, do a good turn daily. For us today, the eagle symbolizes courage, to do one's duty to God and country. The red in the Eagle Scout Award, like the red in our country's flag, represents courage and bravery. The white represents purity. A true Eagle Scout dedicates his life to being pure. And the blue represents loyalty to oneself, loyal to one's country. And an Eagle Scout is a faithful and loyal scout. When the red, white, and blue lay over the foundation for one's entire life, a life of courage, a life of purity, and a life dedicated to being loyal and faithful. All right. So I have a little visual thing that I'm going to do. Being that I never did this before, I'm asking that you give me a little creative leniency.
No. I'm dumb.
I know you wouldn't.
Mark behave.
All right, so basically, what I wanted to do in this section is represent that the scout oath is, on my honor, I will do my best, do my duty to God and my country, okay? God and my country, it's a duty. Duty to yourself and duty to others. Yes, I said duty. I get a giggle, giggle, right? Yeah, okay. All right. So those three parts, you can't live without one or the other. Similarly, I think of the Scout Oath like three parts that water can shape or form. It can be a solid in the form of ice. It can be a liquid. Or, together, it can be a mess. It can be a cloud or steam, all right? You can't, don't blow up. You cannot live without the other two parts. They are three in one. There we go. Okay. Mark Philbrick, another assistant scoutmaster of ours, can you come forward, please? Traditionally, we have in Troop 308 the last Eagle Scout come forward. You waiting with my wife?
No,
that's a good thing. But they're on different sides of the aisle. Are you sure?
Yes.
All right. Traditionally, the last Eagle Scout awards the new or gives the pledge for the new Eagle Scout. Sam Rue is not here today, so I'm going to ask if Mark could do that in his place, please. So in keeping with troop custom, the giving of the Eagle Pledge will be given by Mark to our Eagle Scout. However, before you begin the pledge, I think it's time for another song.
Great.
What do you think?
Sure.
All right. The Grand Old Duke of York is very participatory. All right? So, whenever you hear the word up, what do you think you're going to do?
Stand up. Yeah.
Whenever you hear the word down,
sit down.
And when you're halfway up, there you go. All right. So, the Grand Old Duke of York, he had 10,000 men. He marched them up the hill, he marched them down again. And when you're up, you're up. And when you're down, you're down. And when you're only halfway up, you're neither up nor down. Thank you.
A lot of words.
What's this first name?
Mark.
Oh, yes, that's your name.
Will everyone please rise?
Again.
Who's everyone? I just showed up. Denali Myers Fleurent, you are about to enter the Eagle Scout Brotherhood. In doing so, I charge you to hold before you, without reservation, the ideals of honor and service. By the repetition of the Eagle Scout promise before your fellow members, you will become an Eagle Scout.
Much better.
Though the words you use are similar to those by which you joined scouting, they will mean more today than they could have meant to any other at any time in the past. When you pledge yourself on your sacred honor, you will be sealing your eternal loyalty to the code of the Eagle Scout, using the same words which close the Declaration of Independence. In a gesture of brotherhood, will all Eagle Scouts present in this hall today please give the Scout sign?
Owen.
Denali Myers Fleurent, Scout sign. Repeat after me.
There you go.
I reaffirm my allegiance.
I affirm my allegiance.
To the three promises of the Scout Oath.
To the three promises of the Scout Oath.
I thoughtfully recognize and take upon myself.
I thoughtfully recognize and take upon myself.
The obligations and responsibilities of the rank of Eagle Scout.
The obligations and responsibilities of the rank of Eagle Scout.
On my honor.
On my honor.
I will do my best.
I will do my best.
To make my training an example.
To make my training an example.
Make my rank and my influence count strongly for better scouting and better citizenship in my troop and in my community.
What marks that?
And in my contact with other people.
And in my contact with other people.
To this I pledge my sacred honor.
To this I pledge my sacred honor.
Host.
Host. Don't know if that's an actual part or not. All right. Host. More. Is that?
Denali Myers Fleurent, your eligibility for the rank, for the Eagle rank, has been certified by Scoutmaster Tony Fleurent. That's like cheating, your father. You have accepted the responsibilities of an Eagle Scout and have taken the Eagle Pledge in front of all those assembled in your honor today. By the authority vested in me by the Boy Scouts of America,
very important, that's going to go right to his head.
It gives me great pride and honor in pronouncing you Eagle Scout Denali R. Myers Fleurent. Applause and congratulations.
Good thing we're both over 18.
All right. Will Eagle Scout, you may sit. Thank you. Except Gary. Sorry. Will Eagle Scout and Acting Scoutmaster Gary Russo please come forward and administer the Eagle Charge?
Charge!
Is that a visa card or is that a...
Well, we do have something like that there, but no.
Denali, I have the honor of giving you the Eagle Scout Charge. On the occasion of your elevation, the highest rank in scouting, the Scouts of all nations constitute one most meaningful and significant movement in the world's history. You have been judged by the Boy Scouts of America as being worthy of the honor. All who know you rejoice in your achievement.
I elevated.
Yeah. Eagle Scout Denali Myers Fleurent, I charge you to undertake your citizenship with solemn dedication. Be a leader, but lead only toward the best. Lift up every task you do and every office you hold to the highest level of service to God and your fellow man. So live, serve, that those who would know you will be inspired after a final living. I charge you to be among those who dedicated their skills and ability to common good.
I
help to build America's future on the solid foundation of a clean living, honest work, unselfish citizenship, and reverence to God. By doing this, whatever others may do, you will leave behind your record of you will leave behind you a record of every other scout will be justly proud of. Finally, Eagle Scout Denali Myers Fleurent, I charge you to become the guide to other scouts, an example of your community. Remember that your actions now are a little more conspicuous and that people expect more of you. To falter in your responsibility would reflect not upon you, but upon your fellow Eagles and all of scouting.
I don't know what to say.
Come on down. Do you do?
I do again.
This is Hugh Kahn, came back.
There we go. All right. Thank you, Gary. All right, at this time, I would like to call up several of our scouts who will in turn light these bottles of water that you, or glasses of water that you see behind me, and recite the scout law. Lucas and Thomas, would you please come forward?
Trustworthy. Scout tells the truth, he keeps his promises. Honesty is a part of his code of conduct. People can depend on him. Loyal. A scout is loyal to his family, scout leaders, friends, school, and nation. Helpful. A scout is concerned about other people. He does things willingly for others without pay or reward. Friendly. A scout is a friend to all. He is a brother to other scouts. He seeks to understand others. He respects those with ideas and customs other than his own. Courteous. A scout is polite to everyone, regardless of age or position. He knows good manners to make it easy for other people to get along with and together. Kind. A scout understands their strength and being gentle. He treats others as he wants to be treated. He does not hurt or kill harmless things without reason. Obedient, a scout follows the rules of his family, school, and troop. He obeys the law of his community and country. If he thinks these rules and laws are unfair, he tries to have them changed in orderly manner rather than disobey them. Cheerful, a scout looks for the bright side of things. He cheerfully does tasks that comes his way. He tries to make others happy. Thrifty, a scout works to pay his way and to help others. He saves for unforeseen needs. He protects and conserves natural resources and carefully uses time and property. Brave, a scout can face danger even if he is afraid. He has the courage to stand for what things is right, even if others laugh at him or threaten him. Clean. A scout keeps his body and mind fit and clean if he goes around with those who believe in living by these He helps keep his home and community clean. Reverent. A scout is reverent towards God. He is faithful in his religious duties and he respects the beliefs of others.
Thomas, thank you. Lucas? Everybody still hanging in there? We're almost done. All right. Not that we want to rush this, because it's Denali's time. All right, thank you, Lucas and Thomas, and thank you, Eagle Court. Well, the Eagle Honor Guard, which I haven't yet established, let's see here. Adam, you don't look like you're doing anything, and Mark, let's do it. At this time, will you please escort Tammy Fleurent and Bobby and Ruth Myers to the side of Denali, who's going to come up here. Denali, who's going to come up here. Nope.
Move down.
Yes, I'm just going to hold your arms. Yeah, yeah.
Just one circle so you can buy it off.
Alright, thank you, Honor Guard, who was just asked. With the love and guidance and understanding parents, a boy, without that, a boy is severely handicapped. Your mother and Ruth have watched you grow and develop. They've worked for you in health, nursed you in sickness, guided your thoughts and actions, and helped you in untold ways. Your fathers have been a strength to lean on, someone to turn to in time of trouble and for help. Your home influence will last you throughout your life. They, we, stand, all of us, beside you today as a symbol that we will continue to help you grow in qualities of leadership and citizenship, which an Eagle must have. I would be remiss if I didn't give your mother significant credit for there you go. That's for you, honey. That's your son. It's Superman, but she's a superwoman, as you all know. So that's her song. Alright, thank you, guys. I would be remiss if I didn't give your mother significant credit for backing you and I on over the 100 days plus of campouts and countless meetings over the last 11 years. She's been a great source of inspiration for you in your quest for the Eagle Award, whether in the forefront or supporting you. Therefore, it is surely fitting that I ask Tammy to pin your Eagle badge on your uniform. Thank you, Tammy. Your fathers have stood by you, Denali, over the years and have offered you encouragement and assistance. Bobby, in recognition of the fatherly advice and guidance that you and I have given along our son's Eagle Trail, I ask on our behalf that you would please read this Eagle Scout certificate and present it to our son.
Boy Scouts of America is proud to award the rank of Eagle Scout to Denali Robert Myers Fleurent, Group 308, Fifth Grenade, in recognition of successful completion of all requirements for Scouting's highest rank.
Denali, you've seen how your mothers plan to stand by you in the future. As a token of your love and thankfulness for all they've done for you, please present your mom and Ruth with this Eagle Mother's Pin.
an even better picture. Hold it.
Oh, why do I think that would be a better picture? I don't know. All right, Denali, in recognition of the unselfishness your fathers have shown in helping you to attain the Eagle rank, please present them with this Eagle tie cap.
And a sticker.
Parents a hug, everybody say,
yay!
Yay! Oh, thank you. All right, I was gonna have Jim Wunderlich here. As I mentioned, he recorded a great video that, I'm going to ask Jim's wife, Susan, if she would be willing, on behalf of Jim, if you are willing, yep, on the spot, to present Denali with the presentation of the troop gift. There you go.
What's in the box?
Denali, please accept this eagle, neckerchief, and special gift from the leaders of Troop 308.
All right.
Congratulations.
Thank you, Susan. Very much. Appreciate it.
Yay.
Thank you. All right, Denali will have an opportunity, and actually we're doing pretty good on what I thought would be timing. Denali's going to have an opportunity to present his mentor pins in a moment, but I'd ask if there is anybody who would briefly, and I'm thankful Jim is not here, you can tell him that, congratulate Denali at the podium. You are welcome to come up and say something. Mark. Briefly, and then Riley. Does.
Yes.
Denali, I'm better than you, but I'm proud of you.
This will take all day for your rebuttals.
Rebuttal to that. He may be better, but his camp sucks. I'm on rules.
Over we go. All right, Riley on top.
Good for you.
Thank you. Anybody up? Anybody? Yeah. Derek? Thank you.
I've known Denali for what? 5, maybe 6 years?
I'm sorry, Gary.
That was tough. No, I am an eagle, by the way, so I'd help.
He had more hair.
Yeah, I had more hair too. I did, that's true. Sad, but true. Denali, one thing you remember, I've been eagle for
too long,
40 plus years, and to this day, people light up when I say you're eagle. Truly. Big example, the big lead. Want to stand up here and take this?
It's my present.
You, younger scouts, you guys don't really realize this. It's going to come to you. This is a great achievement. People will constantly light up about it. You don't get it. You'll get better jobs, get better pay, is more expected of you, and they look up to you at all times. The rest of your life. Congratulations.
Anybody else? Going once? Going twice? Well, if you do, then I'm going to, and I don't want that to happen.
What's a few tears a month, guys?
So Denali told me before this that our prayer room that's actually in the student center is where I'm going to be banished for the day if I cry when I do this. So it's a crying room. Well, I just want to tell Denali that we're extremely proud of you, and more so because of the young man that he is. That he is fun and he's outgoing and he's courageous and he's brave and he does what his heart tells him to do. And he is an amazing friend to people. And those qualities were things that he learned by being a scout. And those qualities are going to help him to be an amazing man in the future. And we are very proud of you. We love you.
I'm not going to cry.
There's no doubt.
The lights are bright, okay?
Allergies.
Are you saying something, Andy?
Tony.
Yeah.
Tony.
Now he's going to cry, and then I'm going to cry. And it's like
all the times that we wanted to strangle you.
A fall camp 3-5 years ago. All right.
Yesterday. But it happened.
Yesterday. Yeah.
We truly do love you and extremely proud.
Very nice.
Maybe it's kind of weird for me to be up here. You might be saying, why am I up here? But Denali, I've seen you grow, and you're an unbelievably creative person. I don't want you to diminish the gift that you have. Pursue it, because you are very gifted. I can't wait to see what you do with your life, so good luck to you.
All right, we have a cousin.
So I had a glorious 7 years by myself before Denali came around. And then our world kind of changed a lot. And in our family, we've all been raised very close, almost as siblings. And I can remember the first rally cars that were built and derby cars. And now I'm saying, well, man, what color do I paint it? I don't want it to be stupid. I want it to be cool. And when I said, oh, paint it green, he went, no, I'm going to paint it purple because that's what I like. And I think you need to remember that you are your own person. You're a free spirit. And you should be so proud of yourself for that. And we are so proud of you, even though we don't say it enough. So congratulations.
I see him.
Thank you, Riley, for calling me out.
Yes.
All right. Let's see here. Where are we? Okay. So at this time, I'd like to call up Denali to do his mentor pins. I know. I do remember that. I also remember it was my birthday, and it's not today, so I'm all set. But anyway, thank you, Owen, for reminding me. Before Denali comes up, as one of his dads, I just wanted to say, Denali, it's been a special experience the last 11 years. I truly enjoyed it. Yeah, there's ups and downs, and I, you know, like anybody else, my encouragement is to focus on the positives. That's what makes you great, and I appreciate that you're fun. So, congratulations, and if you'd like to come up now and award your mentor pins, I'll give them to you.
All right, so I'm gonna kind of make this sort of brief. I'm gonna talk a little bit, but I'm gonna have to keep it brief if I don't wanna send myself to the crying room. So I abide by my own rules. So I wanna thank everybody for being out here. It means a lot to me, especially my friends who aren't scouting, friends who aren't scouting, parents, adults, family members, things like that. Before I go on to the mentor pins, there's a couple people I'd like to thank specifically. All the Lewises can come up here, including you, Art. You got to come down here and then hurry up. You, along with Mrs. Lewis and Adam, Adam especially. These three are wonderful people. There were a lot of people that helped me with my Eagle Project. And I thank everybody for helping with that, but the Lewises went above and beyond the call of duty, and they really helped out. I know there were like 3 days after my Eagle Project officially ended that Adam came out and helped me paint, finish putting it together, basically the finer tuned work that didn't require bulk people. And I just wanted to make sure that all three of them got an enormous thank you from the bottom of my heart for being out there helping me after my project officially ended. So, thank you, Adam.
Hip hip, hooray!
All right, now that's out of the way, my first mentor pin, unfortunately he wasn't able to make it, but this guy is incredibly close to my heart. My first year at summer camp, he was my boss. He might possibly be the hairiest man I know. And he really helped sculpt the later half of my scouting career. And he especially helped sculpt my staff career as a staff member. He showed me a lot of things, and I love the guy. My first mentor pin goes to Matt Spaziani. He's not here, he lives in New Hampshire, so he couldn't make it. So that's the first one. The second one goes to someone who's been through thick and thin, has to deal with me very often, more often than most people, actually. He helped me a lot through everything. He's been on most campouts I've been to. He's helped send me to camp. And I'm gonna hold that thought real quick. Shout out to Tommy Casey real quick. Tommy lives in Massachusetts and drove down here specifically for me. So, shout out to Tommy. All right, so back to the mentor pin. Yeah, this guy, actually, he lives with me and has to deal with me every single day. So I give this mentor pin to my dad, Tony.
Yay!
He loves me more, so it's okay.
That is true.
So I actually do have a third one, but the person I'm getting to said he's going to show up, but he hasn't yet, so I'll probably just interrupt while we're all eating and partying to give that one out. But final notes, once again, thanks to Tommy for actually showing up. It means a lot to me, more than he could probably know. And thanks for everybody for showing up. 12 years of my life are coming to a close with the Eagle Scouts. Not coming to a close, I'm still gonna be in Scouts, obviously. It's my life, but thanks for being here.
Thank you. All right, good times. Eagle Scout, Denali Myers Fleurent. On behalf of the members of Boy Scout Troop, PAC, and Venture Crew 308, the troop leadership and everyone here, congratulations and best wishes. I do declare, as Jim Wunderlich said, this Eagle Court of Honor closed, and invite our Eagle Court members, family, and friends to congratulate our newest Eagle Scout and his parents. I would also invite everyone to join us in the Student Center, where many of you have been before, for food, drink, and merry times. Thank you all for coming. Woo!